So you have your four options of your headers, right? I have not graded them yet, but what I've glanced over, for the most part, people who, whichever one you liked the best, I'm good with. So I'd say pick the one that you like the best. I'm going to take this one for now. You're going to copy it. And then you're going to do file new. And in the new, you can go ahead and do web. It'll just get us to pixels. I want this to be 1050 by 200. So 1050 wide, 200 high. You click OK. And then I'm going to do view fit all in window so I can see all of it. And you're going to do paste. And you can kind of play, you're going to have to play around with the size a little bit. The biggest thing that you want to do is group these two and then center it on the artboard. And then you can decide if you want to have color on either of these words. So you can choose either this line or that line to have color. I don't want both to be colored. You can choose one of them to be gray, but that doesn't necessarily count as a color. So you can have like a scheme of gray with a color, gray and black. And then you want to go back to that Adobe color. Or you guys might have wrote down your colors already if you already have those. Great. The one I was working with, I think, was called here, this watermelon one. If you go to edit, it's an easy way to copy and paste the numbers down here. So I'm going to copy this green, the hex code for that. I want to make just my, that one, graphic design and printmaking green. I'm going to double click on the fill and I can highlight that and click OK and it'll turn that color. If I wanted to make this gray, you could go to your swatches. You don't want to make it too light because you need to be able to see it. So I'm going to have that as my header for now. I'm going to save this for the web. File, save for web. We're dealing with text, so I want to make it a GIF. I'm going to leave the white background. I'm going to click save. I'm going to call this, you can put your name on if you want. I'm just going to call it header. I'm going to put it on the desktop for now. You want to save it in your, I'll put the data folder. You want to save it in your data folder. Click save. Then you're going to go to your blog. And if you see it here, you can go to design, or if you click into Blogger, you have, you know, this kind of stuff here. You want to go to layout and you're going to edit the header. And I've had you all name everything graphics. I want you to change this at this point. You're not going to see this except for in this tab when your web page is open. So I want you to put that your first name, last initial. It helps me when I'm grading stuff because I can click on the different tabs and I know who they are. If it just says graphics, 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 I'm not, they're all going to look the same. That was just to make it through, you know, the firewall to make the web page. You don't need a blog description. You are going to have this instead of title and description. If you choose the other stuff, these words will show up. We don't want the words to show up. You're going to choose your file from your data drive. You're going to choose. And then you're going to click save. And you can see it's saving right there. So you have to be patient. Save arrangement. View blog, and there you go. So you'll see that it doesn't move, it stays there. One thing you might want to double check is we are going to go to the template and choose customize. On the widths, we had our blog at, we made the header as 1050, right? So on this width, this part, you want this to be 1050 also. I'm going to apply that to the blog. I'm going to view. And now you'll see it looks a little bit more centered. This side looks kind of big if you want to make that. Let's see what happens if we do this 200. Let's go here, reload it. You can move that stuff over a little bit. So then it's going to give you a little bit more space for your artwork. So under the template, under widths, go ahead for now and do 1050 and 200. Then this is where you can go to the advanced part. This is where you can start changing up the colors to go with the blog. Page text, you want to go ahead and, you know, that can be gray. Mine is gray, or it can be black. Stuff that you're, the backgrounds, all of this stuff needs to stay as is. The links is something you can change. So this is the link color. I'm going to go back to here. Maybe I want my links to be this color. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to go here. And I'm going to get my link color. You see how this changed? So your titles are a link, and anything else that you create is a link. You can have a hover color, so when you roll over it, I don't want it to be blue. That doesn't really match my color scheme. I want that to be, let's do this lighter green when you roll over. And I'm fine with gray as the visited link. Other things you can change. Blog title, you can change the font if you would like to change the font. But I think that's for this one. That would not be post title is what you're going to see. So here you can change the font of your post title. Now you need to make sure it's still matching the feel and the style of, this doesn't really match the, this with that. So you need to make sure you're still matching the feel and the style with what you chose for your header. The header date, this has a background color. You'll notice that colors that I put in my template are already there. You don't have to have a background color, then you need to make sure that you change this stuff. Up to you, so you can kind of play around with that stuff. Page footer, you'll notice it highlights. This has your options for those colors. The gadgets, so that changes the fonts for these. If you want to make it a little bit bigger, it's really big, but this is where you can kind of stylize your blog to make it unique for you. Images, leave all of this. I don't want to have any background color or border around the images. The accents, line separators, that will give you a line here. If you would like that, that's fine. I wouldn't do it past it because it's going to go outside of our template, but if you'd like a line on this side, that's fine, a little dividing line. You can change the color of it. And then we're not going to deal with the CSS. And then you can apply it to the blog. You can view the blog. And then you might not like some of the colors, or maybe you wanted to change this after you did all this stuff. Maybe you realize, oh, I want that to be pink. So if you wanted to do that, you have to go back here. Gets in this layer mode, you can just get out of it. It's grouped, that's why. I can ungroup it now. Maybe I wanted that one to be green and I wanted to keep that dark. Then you have to re-export it or resave for the web. Save. I'm just going to keep it the same name and replace it because I don't want to upload the old one. And I'm going to go to my template. I'm going to go back to Blogger. You have to do this from layout. You're going to go here. You're going to remove this image and you're going to get the new one. And you're going to save. And there you have it. Questions? All right. Go to work.